Now look at the Maltese power. This Maltese did not have a Hindu peasantry. It had Muslim peasantry, Muslim middle class, etc. before 1947. What happened after 1947? Suddenly everyone is part of the same margin. Why did the United Front do so well in 1954? Everyone is in their favor. Why is it that after 1958 so many liberation war movements began? That is because the Sheikh Mujib stood at a time when he he had the confidence of all the people.
A group of benevolent Muslim League activists sat in the altar, decided that they didn't want to have anything to do with India or Pakistan. They wanted an independent state of their own. And the person who gave this information used a very interesting quote, and I use that all the time. He said, if you think of only one man who could become the leader of such a state, that was the tall man from Bangladesh. The point is, Sheikh Mujib was never loyal to Pakistan. So, how do you look at the context in that main Mujib? The way we know him.
You see his continued passage, despite various phases of martial law, military rule coming out of Islamabad, here he is very much a democratic politician, agitating and stirring up the public, making speeches on all of these key issues. And then, of course, the Pakistani authorities decide to go after him with a vengeance. So when he goes to West Pakistan in 65 and actually spells out his six-point formula, saying how we can actually keep Pakistan united, but with these principles to be respected. Instead of seeing in his approach an opportunity to find a reconciliation of the irreconcilables, the Pakistanis chose to go the other way.